Welcome to Fumbling Through Fishing Planet. I'm Sid. Today I'm going to teach you how to catch the unique striped bass right here in California. First thing, I'm going to show you what times you want to fish these bad boys. And on your sunny days, you're going to want to fish like 8 to 10 a.m. like this says. And then again at 4 to 6 p.m. just like this guy says. On your partly cloudy days, which I don't have any click-ups for, it's 5 to 9 a.m. is all. And on your cloudy days, it's 5 to 8 a.m., so a little bit shorter on these cloudy days. And the first spots we're going to go to are the foggy sanctuary. And I'm going to show you spots before baits just because it seems a little easier. So these fish are different than a lot of other fish. Whereas they have, like, they're a school of fish, and the school of fish will move around all over this motherfucker. And you have to basically find the school of fish, catch a couple of them before they move on, and then go and find the school again. So what I do is, like, this little pile of shit here, I'll cast out to it and reel in with some crankbait. And then I'll do it to here if I get bites out there before I get real close, because as you can see close by all the little bubbles, there's a grip of bass and shit close. But I'll cast out there and reel in. If I don't get any nibbles or bites between here and there, I'll move to the next spot and cast out and reel in. And then I'll move down a bit and cast out and reel in. Move down a bit, cast out and reel in. Move down a bit, cast out and reel in. And then once I cast all there, if I don't have any nibbles, I'll run over to this side and do the same. I'll cast out from towards this guy and reel in, because I already cast all this stuff while I was over in the last bit. And then I'll do here, and then like here, and then like here, and sometimes over here, but it doesn't seem like it's the best over here. And then once I cast all those, well, this spot here, well, first off, like, we'll say while I'm here, this spot here, it seems like a pretty good spot for catching all sorts of fish. So if you want to just, like, wait around for the school of fish to come into a zone and fish while you're waiting for them, right here is good, because you'll catch, like, chinooks and all sorts of shit right there. But if you come down here to the dam and run up to the end like this, then you can do the same deal. Cast here, cast here, cast here, cast here, whoop, cast here, and then cast right there until you find these fish. But if you're real lazy, you don't want to go fishing around for them, you can just cast straight out here, anywhere in this area, and reel it into yourself, and just keep doing it over and over and over and over again until they eventually show up. It will work really well with your float, which I'll show you last. But let's show you the baits we can use for these guys. Alright, first, if you're going to be using float stuff, you're going to want some terminal tackle action. And you're going to want to use like a 4-aught up to like an 8-aught. And I think I prefer probably the 6-aught. Works real well. And then, like these jig heads, jig baits, I really didn't have any good luck with them. The hard crankbaits, I was having great luck with these guys. Any of your 6 to 8 foot ones, any of them it seems, 6 to 8 foot. These yellows, and they're the lemons, and the white and blues definitely seem like they're the best between the two, or between all the other colors. Just these two, just doing a slow straight or whatever works great with them. You know, it's funny because these are bass, but these bass jigs didn't do shit. I didn't ever get a nibble or anything off the bass jigs. And then for your spoons and spinners, it seemed like the medium spoon number 6s worked real well. Like, the 4s were okay, but the 6s definitely worked real well. So try these old medium spoon 6s out if you don't want to use your hard baits. And then your bait baits. For your floats, you're gonna want, you know, just your standard issue bass stuff. Like your shiners will work real good. And even though it doesn't say nothing on your large cut bait, it works really good, and your medium works alright, and your minnows works alright, your large ones. Your small minnows work pretty good, your shrimps are okay. And then these ones like grasshoppers and crickets and dragonflies and shit like this down here, it really didn't seem like it was working real well. Not even nightcrawlers. I was barely getting any bites off of nightcrawlers. Nibbles now and again, but not very many bites for sure. But then you want to set your leader deep for the spot. My favorite spot is definitely right here if I'm just gonna sit here and float and wait for him to show up. And so what I do is I set my leader to about 85. Anywhere between 80 and full depth really will work just fine. And then right in this area here above the tips of these trees is really nice. Just cast, like, I cast right at the top of this tree, right about there. See how many feet are out. Yeah, about 77 is real good. About 85 feet and then back to about 60 feet seems pretty good. All right, getting some nibbles. There we go. Come on, old striped bass. We'll reel this bad boy in and check him out. Oh man, see how hard they're pulling? I got a 26 pound reel, 25 pound strain, like a 30 something pound rod, and he is pulling the shit out of it. So that's one thing you're going to want to make sure you have, is at least 20 pound, 20 plus pound line reel get up. 25 is better because look, I'm on 25 and he's still pulling away, no big deal for him. Just have to tire him out and reel him in. Hopefully he'll get tuckered out quick. But who knows, these unis, man, they'll fight for days if they feel like it. Come on, big boy. You just gotta keep working them, getting them to flop on the surface and turning around, changing their direction. Because every time you get them to change their direction, they lose ground, and that is good for you and bad for them. Alright, here he is. Dun dun dun, unique striped bass, just like that. This one's not too bad, 37 pounder, almost a 38 pounder, so not too bad. Good luck, anglers. Hope you guys catch a bunch, and I'll see you next time.